हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम टेस्ट सीरीज नंबर 9। सब्जेक्ट नेम इज एनालॉग सर्किट, टॉपिक नेम इज ऑपरेशन एम्पलीफायर। इट्स अ 2 मार्क्स प्रॉब्लम। सो इन द क्वेश्चन वी कैन सी दैट वी हैव टू स्टेज ओपैम नेटवर्क विद आइडियल ओपैम्स। सो आइडियल ओपैम सेटिस्फाइज द वर्चुअल ग्राउंड प्रॉपर्टी। सो वोल्टेज ऑफ नॉन इन्वर्टिंग टर्मिनल विल बी द इक्वल टू द वोल्टेज ऑफ इन्वर्टिंग टर्मिनल। सो इन द नॉन इन्वर्टिंग टर्मिनल वी हैव 1 वोल्ट एंड 2 वोल्ट सप्लाई। सो वोल्टेज ऑफ इन्वर्टिंग टर्मिनल विल ऑल्सो बी 1 वोल्ट एंड 2 वोल्ट। ओके, now you can see that this 2 kilo ohm, across this 2 kilo ohm resistor we have a 1 volt and 0 volt, voltage difference is 1 volt, so current will always flows from higher potential to lower potential, which voltage difference upon resistor, which is 0.5 milliampere. Okay, similarly this 1 kilo ohm resistor also I can have voltage difference 2 minus 1, 1 upon 1k, so current will be from higher potential to lower potential, which is 1 milliampere. So you can see that at note then we have input current of 1 milliampere and we have outgoing current of 0.5. at any node the KCL should be satisfied. Kelvin's case says that sum of incoming current is equal to sum of outgoing current. We have incoming current of 1 milliampere, outgoing is only 1.5, so we should have addition in the third branch, we should have outgoing current of 0.5 milliampere. Okay friends, so it's a 1 volt and the voltage drop across this 2 kilo ohm resistor is 2 volt, is 2 into 0.5 is 1 volt. So higher potential is 1, so the other node voltage must be 0, 1 minus 0, because the potential difference across this 2 kilo ohm is 1 volt, one node is already 1, so to maintain the potential difference other node must be 0, right? So we can do this thing by assuming the current also, but it's a very trivial calculation, so I think we can do it directly. Again, across this 2 kilo ohm resistor you can see that the potential difference is 2 minus 0, 2 volt. The resistor is 2 kilo ohm, so current will flows from higher potential to lower potential, which is 2 upon 2k, which is 1 milliampere. 1 milliampere is the outgoing current. So let's consider this node 2 volt node. We have a 1 milliampere outgoing current, another 1 milliampere is the outgoing current. So total 2 milliampere current is outgoing. At any node, sum of incoming current is equal to sum of outgoing current. So my incoming current must be 2 milliampere to satisfy the KVL. Right? So higher potential, so current flows from higher potential to lower potential. So my V naught will be almost 2 plus 2k multiplied by 2 milliampere, which is 6 volt. So directly we have got that V naught is 6 volt. We can always do this the same. We can solve this question assuming, you know, naming each and every node and applying KCL in each and everywhere. Actually, we have applied KCL only, you know, but we did the calculation directly just to avoid that, to save the time. These kind of things we can always do in the examination because time is also a factor for us. Okay, thank you.